Hello, my name is Tomáš and I am from Capturing Reality. Today we will take a look at image layers. I will talk about what they are and how you can use them. We will also learn about importance of naming schemes of images and folders. There are many use cases how you can use image layers. For example, you can use them to achieve better geometry in alignment and meshing, create multiple texture maps for look development, to add textures from external cameras, depth maps, masks, and so on. In this episode, we will use full body scanning dataset provided by pi3dscan.com. This one was captured with and without structured light patterns. These images, like this one, are used to enhance detail of geometry and simplify alignment and meshing process. You can see these projected light patterns on her face using this method. Quick tip, to toggle between multiple textures, click on 2D view and press tab to view the next texture and shift tab to view the previous one. Let's take a look at how naming of images works. You have to use this renaming method so Reality Capture can automatically determine how we want to use our dataset. You have two options how to name them. You can rename folders or rename images. You can learn more about renaming images inside Reality Capture help section. Today I'll show you only the easier option, which is renaming folders. Here I created this messy image structure. Let's rename and separate images to folders and rename them so every image from the same camera position will have the same name. Okay, I've created and named these three folders too, underscore geometry, underscore texture 01, underscore texture 02. Using names geometry and texture is required, however instead of underscore suffix you can use comma, at symbol, hashtag or exclamation mark. In this example, underscore geometry folder stands for main folder with images I've chosen for alignment and meshing. Underscore 01 stands for folder with images for creating diffuse texture. If you only want to create one texture, you can also name it underscore texture. Reality Capture can use either or another one. And here is underscore texture 02, which I've chosen for folder with images for creating diffuse texture with projected line patterns. Now I'll open these folders for you. In this folder, underscore geometry, you can see I renamed these photos with a counter from 101 to 223. This is the naming scheme you want to perceive through all three folders, so one camera position will have the same name in all of three folders. For example, look at this image in all of these folders. It's the camera angle taken from the same camera position. Speaking of JPEG, you can also use EXR, HDR, TIFF or any other supported format. In this folder underscore texture 01 there are photos taken with usual flat lighting setup. And in this folder underscore texture 02 there are copy-pasted photos from underscore geometry folder because I also want to create a texture with projected line patterns. I could also create the folder with underscore texture 03 with thermal images as I told in the intro of the video. When I have verified that all camera positions have the same name, I can now open new project in Reality Capture. Now I can drag and drop these folders to Reality Capture. Quick tip, if you have followed naming scheme correctly, you can also drag and drop parent folder, where are all of these subfolders with images, and Reality Capture will automatically assign texture layers to geometry layer. In this tutorial I am using PPI license, you can download it for free, and link is in the description below. Here we can see there are only 116 images. All of these texture layers are assigned to the geometry layer. This is great when using PPI licensing model. You only need to license the inputs from geometry layer and use as many image texture layers as you need without extra charge. If you want to verify all of desired image layers were imported, select one photo in 1DS view, click on 2D view, press tab to go to the next image texture and shift tab to go back to previous one. Okay, everything is imported as intended, so let's align images, create a mesh and create two desired textures. Let's fast forward it. Textures were created automatically for every image texture layer as you can see here. Look at this model in 3D view. If you want to toggle this projected line pattern texture to clean diffuse texture, just open model tree, and under model textures you can see color layer 1 and color layer 2. Click on eye icon here to show texture layer you want to see. Okay, let's recap what we have learned today. Name photos with the same file name across all camera positions in geometry and texture folders. Name folders geometry and texture using underscore, comma, at, hashtag, exclamation mark, and use numbers for texture layers. Verify there aren't any mistakes and image positions are named with the correct file name. Drag and drop parent folder with all the content to Reality Capture. Verify that every desired texture was added with TAB and Shift+TAB in 2D view. Start alignment, meshing, texturing, and export or share it directly to the world. If you liked this episode, please like, subscribe, and comment what you want to see next. Also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and LinkedIn. I'm Tomáš and thank you for using Reality Capture.